You as a patient now are facing the issue of end-stage kidney failure or end-stage renal disease, and your nephrologist is discussing with you dialysis and dialysis options. Information is overwhelming. You're confused about which avenue to pursue, whether you want to do hemodialysis or peritoneal dialysis. I am Dr. Rifai. I'm the virtual nephrologist, and this video particularly will help you at least have an idea about the difference between hemodialysis and peritoneal dialysis and help you have the knowledge to read more and search more and make the right decision for you. First, I'm going to talk about hemodialysis. Hemodialysis is actually, when we talk about hemo means blood in Latin. So hemodialysis is the dialysis of the blood, and it requires an access to your blood circulation. Usually we encourage you to prepare for an access through and what we call a fistula, which is a connection between your artery and a vein. Sometimes it's native, and that is the most preferable form of access. Or it could be a plastic tube in certain circumstances where your veins are hard to connect. And in cases of emergency, we use a plastic catheter we place over the collarbone into the jugular vein. Now, these are the modalities where we have access to your blood, and then we take your blood into a dialysis machine and circulate it and cleanse it. And that's exactly what hemodialysis is. The advantages of hemodialysis are few, where you come 3 times a week, you don't have to do a lot of work, a technician and a nurse are trained to do your dialysis. And you do that, but the disadvantages are many. Your diet is very restricted. You are tied to the dialysis machine and dialysis center 3 times a week. Sometimes you can do it at home. And you have these, what we call hemodynamic, means the blood vessels and the heart go through the ups and downs. On the days you don't dialyze, then the days you dialyze, we relieve the fluid retention, and then we bring you back the following day and you have more fluid retention and so forth. So you will have ups and downs. You will have difficult blood pressure to control sometimes. Your diet is very restricted. You will hear the term potassium, phosphorus, take your binders, watch your potassium. And that is hemodialysis, where we access your blood. Now, based on your circumstances, you may also choose to do it at home, which is the best modality that you can do. It's the same thing, but you do it in your own home and your own convenience. The other type of dialysis, which is called peritoneal dialysis. Peritoneal dialysis does not require an access. It requires a tube that is inserted surgically on the side of your abdomen. And then every night, you will have to do fluid exchanges while you're asleep. Now, this modality of dialysis, which is called peritoneal dialysis, also has advantages and disadvantages. The advantages is, number one, you can do your exchange while you're asleep. You wake up the next morning, voila, freedom. The other advantage that you have is you can take your bags and your exchange material and travel with you. And if you're going on a trip, you can call and have it sent over there, meet you over there, and do your exchanges. So you have more freedom in movement. The diet is a lot more liberal. Potassium intake is not restricted. You're encouraged to eat more protein. Phosphorus is about the same. And it is a good modality, and it has more friendly features to the heart for people who have heart failure. So you as a patient, and you as a family supporting member, you have to work with your patient and decide what is the best modality for myself as a patient. And I hope I can get the support from my family and my loved ones to help me with that decision. And I want to tell you 2 things that I want you to know. The best thing that you can do for yourself is don't deny that you have progressed to advanced stages of kidney disease, because if you place an access in your arm for hemodialysis, you have a chance to reduce the risk of progression for a reason we don't know why, but studies have shown that you place that access early, you can reduce the risk of progression to end-stage kidney disease. So you will do well and you will stay off dialysis for a longer period of time with only placing an access in your arm. For peritoneal dialysis, it is best to have that peritoneal dialysis catheter inserted ahead of time, so you will have what we call soft landing for better dialysis. With this, I hope I was able to shed some light to the difference between hemodialysis and peritoneal dialysis. And then you have the knowledge to seek what is best for you. Talk to your nephrologist again, examine your surroundings, talk to your family, and you can visit our website to the page of choices, and the link is down below. Stay healthy and stay safe. I'm Dr. Rifai, the virtual nephrologist.